Class 230 is a transcontinental, international, multilingual class hailing from many walks of life. We are prior law enforcement, veterans, reservists, cougars, bearcats, huskies, bobcats, longhorns, aggies. Well, technically, we only have one of those. We were Marines, Army, college graduates, medics, and stay-at-home parents before we all found ourselves together last October, ready to take on the challenges at the Academy. Early in the process of acclimating to the Academy, we were introduced to our instructors with distinct styles of imparting knowledge and wisdom on us. Officer Rodriguez is known for being strict, demanding discipline from his classes, and an insistence on progressively shorter and more frequent haircuts. He and Officer Slater took turns during our time at the Academy, handling business with the class and taking care of our house. Officer Webster focused on training cadets to have heart and to study hard. He would say, go home, take a hot shower, kiss the babies, and give me 15 hours in the books. Our defensive tactics instructors, Officers Cardenas, Lopez, and Pedraza, also had their catchphrases, which were instrumental in our conditioning. Easily the class favorite had to be burpees, go. We were trained to find our maximum effort and to then push past our limits. In short, our instructors were single-mindedly focused on preparing officers who are equipped to handle adversity under stress. Many thanks to our class and squad leaders for stepping up when called upon to lead. The work you all did behind the scenes to prepare the squads for instruction was not all me. Was vital to our success. So thank you to Chris Beveridge, Kevin Walker, Chris Pinchoff, and Greg Lawson for leading the squads. Thank you to our class leader, Nate Gadsden, for all the extra stress, behind the scene negotiations, and all the little sacrifices you made throughout our time here. Many thanks are also owed to our instructors who supported us and created an environment where the basics were easy to pick up as long as you were paying attention. The instruction we received will be the difference between life and death at some point in our careers. We've been given the building blocks to start our real education, and for that, thank you. But our gratitude extends far beyond the walls of the Academy. Many of us would not have made it this far without the support of friends and family who have had our backs the entire step of the way. Support came from words of encouragement, delivery of forgotten uniform items, a hot meal, and everything in between. Thank you for putting up with us on our bad days, and thank you for all the good days that we've been privileged to share with you. I cannot stress enough that the profession of policing is a constantly evolving undertaking. Today, the officers who are tasked with holding fellow citizens accountable for their actions are almost unrecognizable from officers just a few generations ago. Yesterday, it was sufficient to chase and catch the bad guys. Today, we must be nimble and keep up with more and more exotic drugs, weapons, legal challenges, and even handling potential patients in need of specialized care for diseases, addictions, and mental health crises. Tomorrow will undoubtedly bring more variety to our workload, and with that, we must remember to be adaptable, to continue learning, and to handle these new challenges with grace and a positive attitude. Our personal development in this department will boil down to our individual commitments to certain traits that must be practiced constantly and faithfully. We must always remain committed to justice by being fair and consistent. We must be wise in our judgments. We must be dependable, take initiative, and act decisively when called upon. We need to maintain tact and bearing by always remaining polite, calm, but firm. Our enthusiasm is vital to every shift, and we must be unselfish, courageous, and loyal teammates. We must be steadfast in our commitment to continually build our knowledge and to maintain our endurance, both mental and physical. Above all else, we must act first with integrity in all that we do. When we arrived at those Academy hallways, We walked in with little more than the last names on our backs. Some of our names are attached to very big shoes, and some of us arrived as blank slates. As we worked and trained at the Academy, we built a reputation around our names. Moving forward, your names are not going to follow you. They will lead you through the doors of every single assignment in your futures. Own that. Never forget where you came from. Never forget the people that helped push you across the finish line and those that have pushed you in spirit. Never forget why you are here, wearing this uniform and serving this community. Most importantly, always make your name mean business. Thank you.